Hi everyone, let's revise permutations and combinations topic today. We will go through all the formulas and properties. We will also see how to arrange alphabets in a word using permutations, how to arrange digits to form a number, combinations concepts and examples, circular permutation examples, and other formulae based problems such as number of triangles, number of parallelograms, number of straight lines that can be formed. Permutation is nothing but an arrangement where order matters. For example, if there's a pin number, say 1, 2, 3, whether you put 1, 2, 3, 3, 2, 1 or 2, 1, 3, they are different. The sequence does matter, right? The position of these numbers do matter and they make a difference. So that's why we call it as permutation, where the order matters or the sequence matters. So if a problem is given, how do you identify that it is permutation? So there'll be keywords like arrange. So this keyword arrange will indicate that you'll have to apply permutation on the problem. Formula for permutation is NPR is equal to N factorial by N minus R factorial. Now, instead of writing this formula, there is also a shortcut where we write the factors, number of factors. So assume, for example, we have NP3 and R is 3 here. So we can write 3 factors, N into N minus 1 into N minus 2. So this is a shortcut. NPN is N factorial, NP1 is N. Now, circular permutation. It is same as the permutation, except that the arrangement here is circular. So example is garland, necklace, round table. Again, here there are two cases. One is, if you can distinguish the arrangement, whether it is clockwise or anti-clockwise, right? In that case, the number of ways is n minus 1 factorial, right? This is n minus 1 factorial. If you cannot distinguish the arrangements, if you cannot distinguish clockwise or anti-clockwise arrangement, then the number of ways is n minus 1 factorial by 2. So example, right? Beads in a necklace, stones in a necklace. We cannot identify whether it is clockwise or anti-clockwise. In such cases, it's going to be n minus 1 factorial by 2. And take another example, people seated around a table. So you can easily identify who are seated in the clockwise direction and who are seated in the anti-clockwise direction. So in this case, the number of ways is n minus 1 factorial. Combination. In case of combination, order does not matter. For example, if you're forming a team, right, or you're forming a committee, or you're forming a group, so in such cases, it doesn't matter who you select first, right? So that's where you'll have to understand that it is combination. So generally, when a problem is given, words such as choose, select, form a team, right? All of this will indicate that you'll have to use combinations there. The formula for combination is NCR is equal to N factorial by N minus R factorial into R factorial, right? So you have additional R factorial here compared to permutation formula. So relationship between permutation and combination is NPR by NCR is equal to R factorial, right? And then this is another important one. You normally get this in a one marker question. If NCR is equal to NCK, then either R is equal to K or R plus K is equal to N. So the question normally would be to find out value of N given NCR and NCK. Then you have another one marker question which is based out of this formula. N plus 1 CR is equal to NCR plus NCR minus 1. So remember these few key properties. These would be useful in our one markers and two markers. Then there are other formulae based problems. For example, number of straight lines that can be formed, number of triangles, number of parallelograms, number of diagonals in a polygon, right? So all of these we will have to memorize. So straight lines is always formed with two points. So remember, so that way we'll have NC2 and KC2. In case of triangles, you need three points to form a triangle. So there is NC3 and KC3. In case of parallelograms, you have two sets of parallel lines, right? So therefore, it is two. And you have two sets. So M is one set and N is one set. And two parallel lines, two straight lines, right? And in case of polygon, so polygon is anything where there are more than two sides, right? So we'll have to use this formula, where it is N into N minus 3 by 2. And the relationship between NPR and NCR is R factorial. So we'll go through first kind of permutation related problems, which is based on arranging alphabets or forming words, right? Key types are when certain number of things always occur together, right? When certain number of things always occur together. So we will have to use unit concept. So certain things that always occur together, they'll form a unit, right? These will form a unit, one unit, and the remaining things will add up and get the total number of things. And the other type is when they do not occur together. In this type, you'll have to find total arrangements and subtract it with number of ways of things occurring together. For example, if we have to find arrangements where all ovals are not together, Then we will have to take the total arrangements and subtract it from all ovals being together. The type 4 is when no two of certain type. For example, you want to find arrangements where no two ovals are together. No two ovals are together. Or no two girls are together. Or no two men are together. So in such cases, we'll have to use an alternate arrangement like consonants in between the ovals. Boys sitting between the girls. Or girls sitting between the boys. So we will have to use this form of finding the arrangement. So you have all girls, in between you have boys. Or you have all vowels, in between you have consonants. So this is another type. We'll go through each of these examples using these specific types. This is a very important one. Permutation of like things. That is, in a word, if you have repeated letters, then it would be, take the total number of letters, right? And number of arrangements. So you have 6 letters here. So 6 factorial by number of repeated letters. So you have n repeating twice. So 2 n's and 2 e's. So you would write it as 6 factorial by 2 factorial into 2 factorial. 2 factorial for n and 2 factorial for e. So this is a key concept. Whenever in any word you see there is repeated letters, you'll have to always use this particular formula. Now let's go through a few simple examples and then we'll move over to 5 markers. In how many ways can letters of the word hopper be arranged? Hopper. So first thing is we'll have to see if there's any repeated letters. So you have 2 letters of P. So 2 letters of P and total number of letters is 6. So what you'll have to do is total number of letters, that is 6 factorial, divide by 2 factorial. This 2 factorial is for 2 P's. So find the number of arrangements. So we have 360 words here. 360 words can be formed with this word H-O-P-P-E-R, hopper. Now another example, how many different signals can be made by taking 3 different colored flags at a time from 7 different colored flags? So if you have n objects, number of r objects which are taken together. So now we are taking 3 different flags from 7 different colored flags. So it should be 7P3. You are taking 3 flags out of 7. So it is 7P3. This is a 5 marker problem where you have to find the number of permutations of the letters of the word Mississippi. In how many ways you can form words where 4 S's are together, right? First one is 4 S's are together. So first thing is you have to find the number of total permutations, right? Before we jump on to A, B, C, D, right? We have to first find out the number of permutations, total number of permutations. So what are the number of letters we have? We have 11 letters. So number of permutations would be 11 factorial by number of repeated alphabets. So we have 4 S's, right? We have 4 I's and 2 P's. So we will have to write number of permutations is 11 factorial by 4 factorial into 4 factorial, 2 factorial. 4 for S, 4 for I and 2 for P, right? This is S for I and P. Now we'll jump over to the first problem, which is 4 S's are together. We'll have to find the number of permutations when 4 S's are together. So we'll have to consider 4 S's as one unit, right? They form one unit. And then we will have to find the number of arrangements that can be made with the other letters. So now let's take this 4 S's as one unit. And so within this letters, within this one unit, you can arrange S's in different places, right? I mean, amongst themselves, you can arrange these letters. So that's why we will have to find the number of arrangements within this unit. They can swap their places, right? So number of ways would be 4 factorial by the number of repeated letters. We have 4 repeated letters. So put that 4 factorial here. So it becomes, it will get cancelled and you'll have 1. So there's only one way that you can arrange these 4 letters. Now we'll come to the remaining letters, right? How many remaining letters are there? We have 4 letters are gone. So out of 11, if 4 are gone, we have left with 7 letters. 7 letters, and then we'll have to also add this one unit because this entire thing we'll have to arrange. We can make different arrangements, right? With MI, II, PPI, and these 4 S's, you can make several arrangements, right? So now find the total number of units or letters. So 7 letters plus 1 unit of 4 S's becomes 8 units. So now we'll have to find number of ways of arranging these remaining letters. So we have 8 units, 8 factorial by repeated alphabets. So you have I repeating 4 times, right? Here you have I repeating 4 times and P repeating 2 times. So 4 factorial to 2 factorial, right? So into one way, that is this one. We'll multiply this and this. Why would we have to multiply? Reason is, we are to make a word, to make an arrangement with these letters, you need to arrange this unit separately, and you'll also have to arrange the other letters separately. So to form one full word, you have to make arrangement of this unit and arrangement of other letters. So basically, when you have to perform multiple operations, arranging this one unit is one operation, arranging the other letters is another operation. When you have to perform multiple operations to form one set or one word, right? In that case, we will have to multiply. So now the number of ways of arranging this 4 S's is multiplied with the number of ways of arranging the other letters. Now there is a case when you'll have to add. We'll come to that when we go through the problem. But remember one thing, few significant steps that we'll have to remember. First, the 4 S's are together. First, find the arrangements of these 4 S's. Then find the arrangement of the remaining letters, including this particular unit, right? And then multiply both of this, right? Arrangements required in the unit and arrangements required for the remaining letters should be multiplied, and that's when we get the total arrangements. Now let's go to the second one, where the 4 S's are not together, right? 4 S's are not together. In this case, we will have to take the total number of arrangements and subtract it from arrangements with 4 S's together, right? So we got the total number of arrangements right here. This is the total number of arrangements. Take this, and we also have the number of arrangements with 4 S's together. So we have number of arrangements with 4 S's together. So we subtract that and we get the total number of ways of arranging where 4 S's are not together. Now we have third kind, which says begin with MISS, begin with MISS. So in Mississippi, MISS should be in the beginning, right? It should occupy the first position. So the place is fixed, the position is fixed. You cannot move this unit anywhere. We call this as a unit now. We can't move this unit. They have to be together and they have to be in the first position. So now what we have to do, the number of ways of arranging this unit. First step is find the number of ways of arranging the unit. So it's only one way because you cannot move them anywhere. It's having only one arrangement. So one arrangement. Now come to the remaining letters. How many letters are remaining? We have 7 letters remaining because 4 letters are already considered. So 7 letters are remaining. Now, do you think we have to add this unit here? Because in the earlier example, we added one unit here, right? But here we will not add that one unit because one unit is fixed. You cannot do any further arrangement with that unit. So you can only arrange this section, that is 7 letters. That's why we are now going to add one unit, right? Remember this. Whenever you have fixed position for letters, you are now going to add that unit in the remaining letters. So now we'll find the third step of finding number of arrangements for the remaining letters, which is 7 factorial by the repeated kinds, repeated letters. So if we have 3 I's, 2 S's and 2 P's. So 3 factorial into 2 factorial into 2 factorial. Now you can also take the last step where we normally multiply number of arrangements of the unit, right? We normally multiply this. Number of arrangements of the unit and number of arrangements of the remaining letters, we multiply both of this. But in this case, if you multiply also, it's going to be the same thing because this is nothing but one arrangement only, right? So this is the final answer. We have another example which says begin with SIP. It's exactly like the earlier one. Now it has to begin with SIP. So SIP, as we know, can be arranged only in one way because it has to be in a fixed place in the first position. Now the remaining letters we'll have to find, which is 8 letters. So 8 factorial by repeated letters. So you have 3 S's, right? Don't consider the S here, right? Just consider the S in the remaining letters. So you have 3 S's and 3 I's. So totally it is 8 factorial by 3 factorial into 3 factorial. So here also, as a final step, we normally multiply this one and this arrangement. So we normally multiply the unit arrangement and the remaining letter arrangement. But in this case, since it is only one, the answer is going to be the same, even if you multiply. So let's go to another example, which is another 5 marker. Find the number of permutations of the letters of the word committee. Now first, we'll have to find the total number of permutations. Don't skip this step. Let's not jump over to solve A, B, C, D. Let's find the number of permutations first. Total number of permutations is, take the total number of letters, which is 9 letters. Find the number of repeated letters. So you have 2 M's, 2 T's and 2 E's. So it's going to be 2 factorial into 2 factorial into 2 factorial. So this is the number of arrangements. Now we'll go to first question. How many of them begin with T and end with T? The word committee should have T in the beginning and T in the end. That means, again, these letters have fixed positions. So first we will take the unit. This is having fixed position and the number of arrangements is 1 for this T, and number of arrangements for this T is also 1, right? So number of ways T can begin and end is only one way. Now we'll find the remaining letters. How many remaining letters do we have? We have 2 letters are already gone out of 9. So we have 7 letters. That means 7 factorial. Here we don't need to add plus 1 unit here because they are in fixed places. You cannot do any arrangement with these letters, right? So that's why you just consider these 7 letters. You can only swap or reposition these letters, not T and T. So we'll take number of letters, remaining letters is 7 letters, 7 factorial by 2 M's and 2 E's. So this is the total permutations for words beginning with T and ending with T. Let's take the second one. In how many ways all the vowels are together? In committee, we have 4 vowels, O, I, E and E, 2 E's we have. So we'll consider 4 vowels as one unit because they have to be together, right? But this unit can be there anywhere, right? It can be here, it can be here, it can be here, it can be here. Anywhere we can position this unit. So number of letters is 4, number of vowels is 4. Now first we will find number of ways the vowels can be arranged. Basically, how can you arrange these 4 letters, right? It can be in different ways. You can have O, I, E, 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 or you can have I, E, 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 O, or E, 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 O, I, right? You have multiple ways of arranging. So that's what we'll find out, number of arrangements for these vowels. So it's going to be 4 factorial by repeated digits. We have 2 E's here, hence 2 factorial. So we have the number of ways this unit can be arranged. Within this unit, you can make these many arrangements. Now we'll go to number of remaining letters. How many remaining letters we have? Totally we have 9 letters, out of which 4 is gone. So we have remaining letters as 5. Now we will have to consider one unit concept here. We'll have to add one unit. Why? Because this one unit can be positioned anywhere. It can be in the first place, second place, fourth place, fifth place, sixth place. See, any place this one unit can be arranged. Hence, we will have to take this into consideration here. Unlike the earlier problem where they had a fixed position. You could not move around those letters. So in this case, we will take 5 letters which are remaining and one unit of vowels together. So we have 6 units. Now, number of ways you can arrange 6 units is 6 factorial by repeated letters. In this case, repeated letters are T and M. T and M. Now, what is the total number of ways? We will have to multiply this 1 and 2. Why 1 and 2? Because first part is giving the arrangements within the unit, right? We are still not forming the entire word, right? We've just found out the arrangements within this one unit. And the second part is arranging the remaining letters with this unit, right? So to form this entire word, the number of arrangements that you can make is you have to multiply this one and this one. Right? For example, you can have O, I, E, E with C, T, T, M, M, or you can have C, O, I, E, 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 this unit with T, T, M, M, or you can have C, T with O, I, E, E, E like this, and you can have like this. So you can have multiple such arrangements, right? So that's why we have to multiply. 1 and 2 has to be multiplied to get the total number of ways. So we have third one, which states that we'll have to find the number of arrangements where no 2 vowels are together. No 2 vowels. Right? Just focus on this. No 2 vowels are together. That means there has to be a consonant in between. Between every vowel, there has to be a consonant because vowels cannot be together. So now we'll have to imagine a arrangement like this. Right? That you have, how many vowels we have? We have 4 vowels in committee. Right? That 4 vowels. Between those 4 vowels, you have the remaining consonants. How many consonants we have? We have 5 consonants, right? We have 5 consonants. So we have one oval, one consonant, one oval, one consonant, right? So we'll have to find the number of arrangements now. Four ovals can be placed in six places. Why six places? So you have five consonants, consonant 1, consonant 2, consonant 3, consonant 4, consonant 5. In between this, you'll have oval. How many spaces are there? 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and the last position. Six positions are there where you can place these vowels. And how many vowels we have? 4. So basically, we'll have to arrange 4 vowels in 6 places. So it's going to be 6P4. We are going to place 4 vowels in 6 places. So it's going to be 6P4. And then let's not forget to put the repeated letters, right, in the denominator. How many repeated letters are there in the vowels? We have 2 E's. So it's 2 factorial. 6P4 by 2 factorial. Now we have found the arrangement for vowels. Now we'll have to find the number of arrangements for consonants, right? We have 5 letters, 5 consonants. So it's going to be 5 factorial by the repeated kinds, 2 M's and 2 T's. So total number of ways is, again, multiply this 1 and 2, you'll get the total number of ways. Last cases, all the vowels are not together. Now, focus on the words here, right? What is the difference between what we went through now and this one? Just look at it. Here, we said no two vowels are together. We said no two vowels are together. In the earlier problem, we said no two vowels are together. But here, we have to find out arrangements where all the vowels are not together. So we have 4 vowels, O, I, E, E, E. They should not be together at all, right? Which means few vowels can be together, but all cannot be together. So you can have something like this, O, I, E, E, and then the word committee, right? You can have that. Or you can have O, I, then the other letters of committee, and then E, E at the end. So this is allowed. But you cannot have something like this, all vowels together and then the other letters of committee. You cannot have all this together. Now, in this case, we will have to use that formula where we say all vowels are not together is equal to total arrangements minus all vowels being together, right? So, total arrangements we already found in the beginning, right? This was the first thing that we did. This is the total arrangements, this one. Now, this we'll have to subtract from. So, we just found it out, right? All vowels are together. We got this one as the total number of ways. So, you subtract it and then you will get the number of ways here. So, just as soon as you get the question right, try to read it carefully because these two seem to look similar. No two vowels are together and all the vowels are not together seem to be confusing. So, read these words carefully. Whenever you see all, right, or something like 4 S's not together, 4 S's not together, 4 T's not together, right, or all not together. Such cases we'll have to take this way. And whenever there is something like no two vowels are together, no two boys are together, no two girls are together, these kind of phrases, you should use this approach of, you should use this approach. Basically, you'll have to alternate. I would call it as an alternate theory or alternate arrangement, just to make it easier. Because when you have no two vowels together, that means there has to be something in between, right? So between vowels, you should have consonants. Between boys, you should have girls. Between girls, you should have boys. So I would call it as alternate arrangement. Just alternate with another set. Then we have the last case where we'll have to find the number of words that we can form with the word ending with might, M-I-T-E in committee. So in committee, the word should end with MIT. So this is again a fixed position and it can be arranged only in one way. You cannot move this unit anywhere. So number of ways MIT can be arranged is just one way. Number of ways remaining letters, we have 5 letters. So 5 factorial. There is no repeated letters here in the remaining letters. So it is just 5 factorial. The total ways is this 1 into 2, which is 1 into 5 factorial. So answer is 5 factorial ways. Now let's go to the next subtopic, permutations with digits. So all this while we saw permutations with alphabets, we'll see permutations with digits. So we'll start from simpler problems and go to the 5 markers. How many 3-digit numbers can be formed using the digits 1, 2, 5, 7, 8? Digits cannot be repeated, right? So with repetition and without repetition, we have 2 ways of calculating the arrangements. So when digits cannot be repeated, so in this case, we have to form a three-digit number. So just draw this three-digit boxes. The first digit, how many ways the first digit can be filled? We have five digits. So you can have five digits here, any one of the five digits. So it is five. Once you put the first digit, then how many digits are left? You have four digits. So second digit can be filled from four digits. And third digit, you have three digits left. Right? So 5 into 4 into 3. Other theory is 5P1. What is 5P1? You have to choose one digit out of 5 digits. What is 4P1? You have to choose one digit out of 4. Because once you have selected one digit, you cannot repeat it. Right? Then you'll have to take the remaining digits. So it's going to be 4P1. Now once you select first digit and second digit, once you select this two, then what you are left with? What are the number of digits you are left with? Two are already selected. And you have 5 digits here. So you'll have 3 digits. 5 minus 2 digits, 3 digits is what you're going to be left with. So it's going to be 3P1 because you have to select one digit from remaining 3 digits. So 3P1. Again, 5P1 is 5, 4P1 is 4 and 3P1 is 3. So it's going to be same as this one. So either you use this approach, it's going to be the same thing. Right? Same answer, 60 ways. Now we'll take the next problem. How many 6-digit numbers can be formed from the digits 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, no digit being repeated, which are divisible by 5? To find 6-digit numbers. So let's draw these 6 boxes here, which are divisible by 5. So only numbers ending with 0 or 5 are divisible by 5. In this set, 0 is not given. Only digit that is given is 5. We can have only 5 here in the last place. Now we will see how many arrangements that you can make with this last digit being 5. Only 1. Because you can have only 1 digit in the last place. 1. One way. Let's come to the first digit. Now one digit is already chosen, right? Now how many are left? Out of 6, 1 is chosen, so you are left with 5. So you have 5 digits to select one digit. So it's nothing but 5P1. You have 5 digits and you have to select one. Next one is, once you have selected one digit here, you are left with 4 digits. So 4P1, 3P1, 2P1, 1P1, and then you have 1 here. So you multiply all of this and it becomes 120 as the answer. Now, slight modification to this problem. What if it was told that digits can be repeated? If digits could be repeated, then this is going to be total number of digits, right? Total number of digits is 6. So it's going to be 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, and 1. Digits can be repeated. So you have 6 digits here. This would be the answer. 6 into 6 into 6 into 6 into 6 into 1 for a case where digits can be repeated. How many numbers between 300 and 3000 can be formed with the digits 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5? Between 300 and 3000. So we will have to make two cases here. One with 3-digit number and one with 4-digit number. So with 3-digit number, let's draw 3 boxes. The number should be between 300 and 3000. The first digit should be between 300 and 3000, means it should be greater than 300. So you can have, the number should start from 3, 4 or 5. It cannot be 0, 1, 2, right? It has to be 3, 4, 5 because it's greater than 300. So you have 3 numbers, which means you have 3 ways. Now let's come to the second digit. Second digit, how many digits do we have? We have totally 6 digits, right? Here they have not stated if repetition can be done or not, right? I'm assuming that we can repeat, right? Because it's not given. So I'm assuming that it can be repeated. So since it can be repeated, even though I've chosen one number here, I still have all the digits to select here. So I still have 6 digits, 6 here. And even the last digit, I have 6 digits. So it's going to be 3 into 6 into 6. It's going to be 3 into 6 into 6, which is 108, this one. Now we'll go to the second case of forming 4-digit number. So let's draw 4 boxes here. Now, to form a 4-digit number, it should be within 3000. That means it should be less than 3000. That means the only two numbers are 1 and 2. Right? We cannot have 4 and 5 because it's going to be more than 3000. So, we can have only two numbers. So, two ways. And the second digit, you have 6 digits. 6, 6, 6. So, it's going to be 2 into 6 into 6 into 6. So, it's going to be 432. So, now we'll have to add up. Total number of ways is this one and this one. When you add, you're going to get total numbers that can be formed between 300 and 3000. So it's 540 numbers. Here's another example where we'll have to find out how many 4-digit numbers can be formed using digits these 6 digits are given, we have to find 4 digit numbers. Digits can be repeated, right? So remember one thing, whenever in the set that they have given you, right, 0 is there, ignore that 0 here, right? Because the first digit can never be a 0. So how many digits you have? You have out of 6, you have only 5, because we are not considering 0 here. 2, 3, 5, 7, 8 is what we have, 5 digits. So 5 ways. For the second digit, you have all the 6 digits. Digits can be repeated. So we'll have 5 into 6 into 6 into 6 into 6. The last digit also, we'll have 6 digits to select from. So the number of 4 digit numbers is this one. Total number. So it's 1080. Again, let's not jump over to A, B, C, D. Let's first find out the total number of arrangements, right? Total number of arrangements is 1080. Now let's come to part A. What is part A? How many of them are even? And what is the condition for the number to be even? The number should end with even number. So now in this set, how many even numbers we have? 0, 2 and 8. 0, 2 and 8. So we can have this last digit populated with 0, 2 or 8. So we have 3 possibilities, 3 ways basically, right? Now we'll come to the first digit. First digit, 0 cannot be included. So how many digits we have? Remember, your digits can be repeated. So it doesn't matter whether you have selected it or not. We have 5 digits here, excluding 0. Then the second one you have 6. Third one also 6, right? So it's going to be, total arrangement is going to be 5 into 6 into 6 into 3 for the last digit, because it has to be an even number. Now, how many of them are divisible by 5? Now, what is the condition for divisible by 5? The last number, the last digit can be either 0 or 5. So we have 0 and we have 5 given here, right? So you have 2 ways of populating the last digit. Now let's come to the first digit. First digit is, again, 0 needs to be excluded. So how many digits do we have? We have 5. 5 ways. Then second digit and third digit, you have all the digits. You can choose from any of these digits. So you have 6 digits. So 6 ways. Third letter also same thing. So totally it's going to be 5 into 6 into 6 into 2. This 2 is for 0 or 5. So 360 ways. Third one is, how many are greater than 5300? Here it's slightly tricky. How many are greater than 5300? That means we will have to check first place and second place. Greater than 5300. And we'll have to find 4 digit numbers, right? 4 digit number greater than 5300. So that means the first digit can be either 5, 7 or 8, right? 5, 7 or 8. So you can have either 5 or 7 or 8. Now I have splitted this into 2 cases. Why? So whenever you have a restriction like this, right? 5300, 7500, 75,000. So whenever you have something like this, where you have 2 digits involved, right? If it was just greater than 5000, then you just need to worry about the first digit. First digit can be 5, 7 or 8, right? 3 ways. But here we have 5300. So we have second digit coming into the picture, because of which we will have to split the cases now. We'll have to take case 1, which starts with 5. If it starts with 5, then second digit should be 3 or more than 3. It should be 300, right? So it should be 3 or more than 3. So 3, 5, 7, 8. You can have 4 digits here. 3, 5, 7, 8. So you have 4 ways. Then third and fourth digit can be anything. It can be repeated. So 6 digits. Total number of ways is 1 into 4 into 6 into 6, 144. Now we'll go with the second case. Here in second case, the first digit can be 7 or 8. 7 or 8. So here second digit, we don't have to really worry, because the moment a number starts from 7 and 8, it's going to be more than 5,300. It's going to be greater than 5,300. So 7 or 8, 2 possibilities, 2 ways. And the remaining digits, you have 6 ways. Right? Because there are 6 digits, you can choose any of those 6 digits and it can be repeated. So total number of ways with 7 or 8 as the starting digits would be 2 into 6 into 6 into 6, 432. Now we'll have to add both these cases, because with this you will find some set of numbers and with this you will find some set of numbers. Total set is, you'll have to add both of this. To reiterate, whenever there is a second digit involved, split the cases, don't merge them, split it. Take case 1 with first digit and take case 2 with other combinations of first digit. How many of them end with 7? Straightforward. The last digit is fixed, 7, only one way. And the first digit cannot have 0. So out of 6, 1 is gone. We are left with 5 digits. And the remaining digits are going to be 6. Because repetition is allowed. So 5 into 6 into 6 into 1. 180 ways. Let's go to the next problem. How many even numbers greater than 300 can be formed with the digits 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, no digit being repeated. So there is no repetition allowed here. And you have to find even numbers. And then it should be greater than 300. So three conditions are there. Now the numbers should be greater than 300. So we have five digits. So what is the maximum number that we can form? It can be a five digit number only. That's the maximum that you can find, right? So that means you can have numbers with 3-digit, 4-digit and 5-digit, because we have been given with 5 digits here. So we'll have to take 3 cases with 3-digit, 4-digit and 5-digit. We'll have to take 3 cases. Case 1, 3-digit numbers. So it should be greater than 300. So let's draw 3 boxes first. It should be greater than 300, which means the first digit can be 3, 4 or 5. 3, 4 or 5. It cannot be 1 and 2. 3, 4 or 5. So how many ways? 3 ways. And the next 2 digits, remember, it's like also the number should be even. So the last digit can be 2 or 4 only. That means there are only 2 ways for the last digit. The middle digit, no digit can be repeated. So you have chosen 1 year. You have chosen 1 year. 2 are already chosen. You have 5 digits. 2 are already chosen. What is remaining? 3 digits. So 3 ways. So multiply all of this and you get 3 digit numbers. There is 4 year and there is 4 year. Even number, so you can have 4 year. And it should be greater than 300, so you can have 4 year also. So now you can't have 4 in both the places, right? 4 can be only in one place. So we'll have to take cases here, right? With 4 at the end. If you choose to have 4 as the last digit, then you cannot have 4 in the first digit. So in that case, you'll only have 2 ways. It either can be 3 or 5. So it's going to be 2 ways. And second one, of course, it's only 3. And the last one is going to be only 1, because we have chosen to have 4 there. So 6 ways. Now we'll have to go with another case, split case in this, with 2 at the end. When you have 2 at the end, it doesn't matter because there is no 2 here. So you can keep 2 here, which is one way, right? One way of having 2 in the 2 as the last digit. And then you can have 3, 4, 5 in the first digit. So 3 ways and 3 ways. So 3 into 3 into 1. So now the total number of ways would be, you have to add these two. So it's going to be 15 ways. Now we'll have to go to second case with 4 digit numbers. 4 digit numbers is, draw 4 boxes here. It should be even number. So the last digit can be 2 or 4. 4 digit number. Obviously it's going to be greater than 300. So it can be, what are the numbers here? 4 digit numbers. So if you are putting 2 and 4 here, what are the remaining numbers? Remaining numbers are going to be 1, it's going to be 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So these are the numbers that we have. Now we choose either 2 or 4 in the end as the last digit. So how many we are left? We are left with 4. One digit is chosen. We are left with 4 here. And the second digit is 3, third digit is 2. So this is the total number of ways, 4 into 3 into 2 into 2, 48. Similarly, we'll have to do for 5 digit numbers. 5 digit number, again, it has to be even number. So this is 2 ways. Then come to the first digit, you have 4 ways. 5 digits, 1 digit is already chosen. So 4 digits are left, 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. Now the total ways we'll have to add all of this. Case 1, case 2, case 3, we add and we get the total ways. How many 5 digit numbers can be formed using digits with no digit being repeated? So you have 7 digits here. How many 5 digit numbers? So it's going to be 7 into 6 into 5 into 4 into 3, right? Just draw 7 boxes. And how many 5 digit numbers you can form is nothing but 7 into 6 into 5 into 4 into 3, 2520. Now we'll go to finding numbers which are less than 50,000. Less than 50,000. So less than 50,000 means the first digit can be 1, 2 and 3 out of this set. It can be 1, 2 or 3. It cannot be 5. It cannot start with 5 because it should be less than 50,000. So we have 3 ways to choose the first digit. Second digit, no digit can be repeated. So 1 digit is already chosen. So out of 7, 1 is chosen. You are left with 6. For third digit, 2 digits are already chosen. So you are left with 5. For fourth digit, so you have 4 and then 3. So this is the total numbers with less than 50,000. Greater than 75,000. This is like that example of 5,300 case. So you have first digit and second digit coming into the picture. When you have this, you'll have to split the cases. You'll have to split the cases. Take the first digit with 7 and the second digit as it has to be greater than 75,000. That means the second digit can be 5, 8 or 9 in this set that they've given. The set they've given is 1, 2, 3, 5, 7, 8, 9. They've given 1, 2, 3, 5, 7, 8, 9. So the second digit should be greater than 75,000. So it can be 5, 7, 8, 9. Now you cannot have 7 as second digit because the first digit has to be 7. We are taking numbers greater than 75,000. So case 1, first digit is 7. You have one way. Second digit can be 5, 8 or 9. So 3 ways. And then the last few digits is 2 digits already chosen out of 7. So left with 5, then 4 and 3. So this is the case 1. Now case 2 is with first digit being 8 or 9. So 2 ways. And then the remaining digits are, you've already chosen 1 out of 7. So 6, 5, 4, 3. Now you add case 1 and case 2 number of arrangements, right? 180 plus 720, you're going to get the total arrangements. Let's take an example where we have to find in how many ways can 7 English books, 8 Kannada books and 5 Hindi books be arranged in a shelf. So first we have to find the number of arrangements that can be made with 7 English books, 8 Kannada books and 5 Hindi books. The total arrangements we have to find. Total books we have is 20 books. So it's going to be 20 factorial. Now let's go to part A, which is all Kannada books are together. So now again we'll have to use the unit concept. Number of Kannada books is 8. Number of ways of arranging Kannada books is 8 factorial. 8 books, 8 factorial. Then we have to find out number of remaining books plus this one unit of Kannada. Number of remaining books is, you have 7 English and 5 Hindi, which is 12 books. And then we have to consider this unit, right? Because we can shuffle this unit between English books, between Hindi books, right? So the total arrangement is 30. The total units is 13 and arrangements would be 13 factorial. Now we'll have to multiply this 1 and 2 to get the total arrangement. Part 2 is no two English books are together. No two English books are together. Remember this. No two. Whenever you see this two English books, two, that means it's an alternate arrangement. There has to be something next to that English book. So it can be a Hindi book or a Kannada book. So it will be something like this. These are the English books, say, right? These are all English books. And in between you can have either Kannada books or Hindi books. So now we'll have to find how many places are there for English books. We have 14 places. 8 Kannada books. In between 8 Kannada books you have. And in between 5 Hindi books. How many places you have? 8 plus 5 is 13 and plus 1 extra space. Add 14 places. If you count the corners, it's going to be 14 places. And how many English books? It is 7. So 14 p 7. We have to place 7 books in 14 places. So it's 14 p 7. Then number of ways that you can arrange remaining books, that is Kannada and Hindi. We only found out how English books can be arranged. Now we'll have to come to arrangements for Kannada and Hindi, right? Number of remaining books is 13. Kannada and Hindi is totally coming to 13. So 13 factorial. Total number of ways is, you have to multiply this 1 and 2. This 1 and 2 will give you total number of ways. Now next one is books of same language are kept together. Same language. So English books together, Kannada books together, Hindi books together. 7 English books, so 7 factorial. 8 Kannada books, so 8 factorial. 5 Hindi books, so 5 factorial. Totally, here there are 3 units. This is 1 unit, this is 1 unit, this is 1 unit. 3 units, right? And within these units you can arrange. You can first have this 7 books, 7 English, then 8 Kannada, 5 Hindi. Or you can have 5 Hindi, 7 English, 8 Kannada. Or you can have 7 English, 5 Hindi, 8 Kannada. So you can, you know, sequence these books in any way. Basically, each of them is a unit. So you can sequence them in any way. You can change the order. That's why the number of units is 3. Number of arrangements is going to be 3 factorial. Now we'll have to multiply all of this, 1, 2, 3 and 4 to get the total number of ways. Now all Kannada books are together and all Hindi books are together. So basically they have given 2 units now. Kannada books should be together, so 8 factorial. Hindi books should be together, so 5 factorial. Remaining books, what are the remaining books? We have 7 English books plus 2 units. This one unit and this one, 2 units. So 9 units totally. So it's 9 factorial. Now you multiply 1, 2 and 3 and you're going to get the total number of ways. Let's go to the next subtopic, which is combination. So like I mentioned, for combination order doesn't matter. The keywords are choose, select, form a team, form a party, form a committee. All of this indicate that you'll have to use combinations. Now let's go through an example. A box contains 5 red, 4 black and 3 white balls. how many selections of 8 balls can be made if the selection process contains exactly 4 red, 2 black and 2 white. So simple, there are 5 red, you have to have exactly 4 red. So 5C4, you have to select 4 red balls out of 5, 2 black balls out of 4 and 2 white balls out of 3. So just multiply these and you're going to get the total number of selections. Why you have to multiply is because you have to form 8 balls, right? And to form 8 balls, internally you have an arrangement between red, between black and between white. So you have 3 operations to do. And all together, if you club all 3 operations together, then only you're going to get 8 balls. So that's why you have to multiply. Next case is at least 3 red, at least 3 black and at least 1 white. So at least means it can be greater than 3, greater than 3 year and greater than 1 year, greater than 3 red. So total red that we have is 5 red, 4 black and 3 white. At least you should have 3 red. So it can be greater than 3 red. So we'll take first 3 red here. Just start with red here. So you need to have 3 red at least. So start with the minimum number, which is 3. Then we'll go with the next number, which is 4. Then we'll go with the next number, which is 5. So we'll keep on going like this until form a combination, right? So with 3, how many blacks you can have? You can have either 4 black or 3 black. Minimum is 3 black, right? So either it should be 3 or greater than 3. 3 black or 4 black. Similarly, white ball also you can have. There are 3 white balls. You can have 1 white ball, 2 white ball or 3 white ball. But we'll have to ensure that the total is 8 balls. So you start with 3. Then you need another set of 5 balls, right? That means you should have 4 black and 1 white. This is one combination. Then you can have 3 black and 2 white. So you need 5 here, right? You need 5 if you choose 3 red. So now multiply the combinations here. 5 out of 5 red, you need 3 red. Out of 4, you need 4. So multiply these combinations and you'll get the total base here. Now let's go to the next set. Next set, you'll have to start with 4 red. With 4 red, what are the possibilities? You can have 3 black, 4 black, 5 black, right? But with 4 red, you need, what should be the total? You need to have 4, remaining 4, right? 4 is chosen, you need another 4 balls because you need total 8 balls. So you can have 3 black, 1 white. Can you have 4 black? You cannot. If I have 4 black, I have 4 red, it's going to become 8 here. But I need a white ball, right? It's mandatory to have a white ball. So I cannot take this combination. Can I have 5? No. The maximum black balls is only 4, so I cannot have 5. Next is, can I have something like this? 4, 4, 3 and 2, 2 white balls. No, right? Because already it's exceeding 8. So like this, we'll have to figure out all the combinations and get the total combination and total it up, right? Add up all these. We have to add because this entire arrangement, you are forming 8 balls. It is one full set is formed. One full set is formed here. And here you have another set with different combinations. You have the third set. So you have multiple sets. When you have multiple sets or multiple choices, then you add. But internally you multiply. See, internally within this set, you multiply. 5 red balls, 4 black balls and 3 white balls. Within this you multiply. But once you form the entire set, then you have to add it with the next set. Let's take another example where a team of 8 players has to be selected from 14 players. In how many ways the selection can be made if 2 particular players are always included? 2 particular players are always included, which means 2 have been selected. So out of 8, 2 have been selected. So how many players need to be selected? 6. 6 need to be selected. And what is the total number of players we have? 14. Out of 14, 2 are already included. So how many remaining? 12. So basically, out of 12 players, we have to select 6. Simple. So it is 12C6. 2 particular players are always excluded. That means they are removed. So we have 14 players and we need to select 8 players, right? In 14 players, 2 are excluded. So left with 12. And we still have to select 8 players from 12. So it is 12C8. We have to still form 8 players, select 8 players out of 12 players because 2 are already excluded. So we have 12. So it is 12C8. From a class of 9 boys and 7 girls, 12 students are to be chosen for a competition which includes at least 6 boys and at least 4 girls. A particular boy is already chosen. Right, is already chosen, and we need to have total 12 students. Total students is 12, and we have 9 boys. 1 boy is already chosen, so left with 8 boys, 7 girls. Right, 1 is already chosen, so left with 11 students. And out of 9 boys, 1 is chosen, so left with 8. So now with this, we'll have to form combinations. So we'll start with 5 boys. You should have minimum 6 boys. Out of 6 boys, one is already chosen, so that means the minimum should be 5. So you start with minimum. Right, start with minimum 5 boys. If you have 5 boys, how many girls you should have? You should have total 11 students. That means you should have 6 girls. Then you increase this, make it 6 boys, so 5 girls. Increase it to 7 boys, 4 girls. Increase it to 8 boys. If you take 8 boys, then how many girls you should have? 3. But you should have minimum of 4 girls. So you cannot take this combination, strike it out. So you should, so you only have 3 sets. So add up these 3 sets and you'll get the total combinations. Circular permutation. So as mentioned before, right? If you cannot distinguish between clockwise and anticlockwise orders, then the formula is n minus 1 factorial by 2. Example, arranging 8 different colored beads in a necklace. You cannot really identify whether the beads are in clockwise direction or anticlockwise direction. It doesn't matter in a necklace, right? That's why it's going to be n minus 1 factorial by 2. So n is 8 here, 8 beads. So 8 minus 1 factorial by 2 is what we'll get, 7 factorial by 2. The next one is when you can distinguish between clockwise and anticlockwise. So this is an example. In how many ways can 10 people be seated around a table? So in a table, you can find out who are sitting in clockwise direction and who are sitting in anticlockwise direction. Hence, people have to use n minus 1 factorial here. N is 10, so 10 minus 1 factorial. Find the number of ways in which 8 men can be arranged around a table so that particular men may not be next to each other. They cannot be together. So we'll have to use formula where we say total arrangements minus 2 men together. Total arrangement is you have 8 men. So it's a circular arrangement. So it should be n minus 1, which is 8 minus 1, 7 factorial. 2 men together is 1 unit, that is 2 factorial. Remaining men plus 1 unit. Remaining men are 6 men because 2 are already in 1 unit. 6 men plus this 1 unit, 7 units. So arrangements is n minus 1, which is 7 minus 1, 6 factorial. The total arrangements with 2 men together are 2 factorial into 6. That is, we have to multiply 1 and 2. And then the final one, total arrangements with no 2 men together is total arrangements minus 2 men together. So total arrangements we got was 7 factorial minus this one, whatever we obtained here. In how many ways can 10 beads of different colors be strung into a necklace if red, green and yellow beads are always together? So there are 10 beads, 3 beads are always together, 3 colored beads are always together. So remaining 7 beads. So now within, we consider these 3 beads as one unit. So what is the number of arrangement? 3 factorial, because there are 3 beads, 3 factorial. And what are the remaining beads we have out of 10? 3 are gone, 7. And then we have to take this as 1 unit. 7 plus 1, 8 unit. So number of arrangements for remaining beads is 8 minus 1 because it's circular permutation. So 8 minus 1, 7 factorial. Now the total arrangements, let's not forget to multiply. It is 3 factorial, 1 into 2, 3 factorial into 7 factorial. In how many ways can 6 boys and 6 girls be arranged in a circle so that no 2 boys are together? So no 2 boys are together means that means there has to be a girl in between, right? So we'll have to first find arrangement for girls. So number of girls is 6. Number of arrangements is n minus 1 factorial because it's a circle. 6 minus 1, 5 factorial, right? Now we'll come to boys. Boys have to be sitting between girls because boys can't be together, which means we have to find the number of spaces. Number of spaces between girls. We have 6 girls, so spaces would be 6. In case of circular permutation, spaces would be equal to the number of objects. So we have 6 girls, 6 spaces. So number of boy arrangements is 6 factorial. For boy arrangements, we're not doing n minus 1 factorial. Why? Because the boys are restricted. Their positions are restricted. It's no more, they cannot be placed anywhere in the circle, right? Though it's a circle, they cannot be placed anywhere. They have to be between the girls. So if you look at 2 girls here, they have to be between here. So this becomes this is a non-circular permutation. It's linear. So that's why we're going to use linear permutation, which is 6 factorial. Or 6P6 because there are 6 spaces for 6 girls. We're not going to make it as circular permutation. So we're not going to use n minus 1. But for girls, girls can be seated at any point, anywhere they can be seated, right? They can form a circle. But for boys, it's between the girls. Hence, for girl arrangements, we use circular permutation, which is n minus 1. And for boy arrangements, it's linear. So it's directly 6 factorial. Now we multiply this and this 1 into 2 and we get total arrangements. In how many ways can 7 gentlemen and 5 ladies be arranged in a circle if no 2 ladies are together? This is just like the earlier example. Here 2 ladies cannot be together. That means between 2 gentlemen, there is a lady. Same case. Number of arrangements with men is circular. Because men can be seated anywhere, it's the ladies who are restricted. So men are in circular arrangement, 7 minus 1, n minus 1. And ladies, it is 7P5 because we consider ladies as linear permutation here. Because they are between 2 men, they cannot just take any point in the circle. They cannot sit anywhere. So between 2 boys. So in such cases, it is 7P5 because there are 7 spaces, 7 men. So there are 7 places in between and 5 ladies to be selected. So 7P5. multiply 1 and 2, that's the total arrangements. Find the number of ways in which 10 flowers can be strung into a garland. If 3 particular flowers are always together, 3 flowers, so it's 1 unit. Within 1 unit, you can make arrangements. So that is 3 factorial, right? Within 1 unit. Number of remaining flowers is 7. And then this 1 unit you have to consider, 8 units. And it's circular permutation. So 8 minus 1, n minus 1. So 7 factorial. The total ways is 1 into 2. Find the number of ways in which 15 staff members can be seated around a circular table for a meeting if the vice president and dean have to be on either side of the principal. So the positions of the vice president and dean is fixed. So they have to be adjacent to the principal. VP is adjacent to the principal and dean is also next to the principal. So the number of arrangements for these three people is, there are 2 arrangements. Because VP can sit on the left-hand side of the principal or on the right-hand side of the principal. Similarly, dean also. So there are only 2 possibilities, right? 2 ways. That's why it's 2 ways here. Principal is sitting in a fixed position, in one position. And on one side it is VP, on the other side it is dean. Then the dean and VP can swap. So 2 ways. Number of arrangements for remaining members, 3 are here. Leftover members are 12. 12 members. And then you consider this as 1 unit. So 13. 13 units. So 13 minus 1 factorial, n minus 1 factorial, circular permutation. Then take this arrangement and this arrangement, 1 into 2, you'll get this total arrangements. Let's go to a few 1 markers and 2 markers. Find n if ncn is nc15. So there is a property. If you have, if nck is equal to ncr, then n is equal to k plus r or k is equal to r. Remember this. So just add this 10. Assume that this is k and this is r. Add these numbers 10 and 15. And n is going to be 10 plus 15, which is 25. Now in this case, there is another property. If ncx plus nc7 is 10c7. That is, n plus 1 cr is equal to ncr plus ncr minus 1. You have to remember this property. So you can see the difference here, right? It is similar actually. N plus 1 cr, that is 10c7. 10c7 is nothing but 9 plus 1 c7 is equal to 9c7 plus 9c7 minus 1. We can write it in this form. See, if you write it in this form, 9 plus 1 c7 is same as 10c7. 9c7, 9c7. Then you have ncr minus 1, which is 9c, r is 7 here, because we have taken r as 7 here. 7 minus 1. So now, as per the formula, this is cx. 9cx. This is same. This is same. So what we can infer? 9cx is equal to 9c7 minus 1. Therefore, x is equal to 7 minus 1 and x is equal to 6. Let's take another case. If npr is this much and ncr is this much, find r. So we'll have to remember this property. npr by ncr is r factorial. Npr value is given. Ncr value is given. You'll get r factorial. So r factorial is 120. Now you just have to guess here. So there's no way you can find out r. You have to guess. What will give you 120? You'll have to try. 4 factorial. Will it give? 4 factorial is 4 into 3 into 2, 1. 3 factorial you should try. You should try 5 factorial. So whenever you get 120, you'll have to stop. So here, if you use 5 factorial, you'll get 120. So r is equal to 5. Find r if 25, if this expression, right? There is another property which says, if ncr is equal to nck, then r is equal to k. Earlier we said n is equal to r plus k in the earlier examples. In the same property, you can either have this or this. So here we'll use r is equal to k. That is r plus 3 is equal to 2r minus 3. That therefore r is equal to 6. Now we'll take other formulae based problems. That is finding the number of straight lines, triangles, parallelograms. Let's go through examples. Find the number of diagonals of a polygon of 20 sides. So number of diagonals formula is n into n minus 3 by 2. Use that formula and you'll get number of diagonals. Similarly, for number of parallelograms, they've given 6 parallel lines intersecting another set of 4 parallel lines. So this is M, this is N. Formula is MC2 into NC2. M is 6 parallel lines, N is 4 parallel lines, and we'll get the number of parallelograms. Now this is slightly reverse. If they've given 170 diagonals, we'll have to find the number of sides. The formula we have is N into N minus 3 by 2 will give you number of diagonals. Here they've given you diagonals as 170. You'll have to find N, that is number of sides. So you'll get this quadratic equation. Now with this, you'll have to find the values of n. So to find the roots, right, or to find the value of n, there is this formula. We'll have to use this formula and get the roots. Consider this as ax square plus bx plus c. You have to consider this as this form and then use this formula. B is nothing but this one, coefficient of x. A is coefficient of x square and c is the number. We'll have to use this and then get the roots. So you have plus or minus here. Take first with plus. 3 plus 37, 3 minus 37, you'll get 2 numbers. So obviously the number of sides should be positive, right? You cannot have negative number of sides. So take the positive number, which is 20. Now another case, if NP phi is 24 into NCN, find N. So we'll have to use the relationship formula here. NPR by NCR is equal to R factorial. So instead of NC4, we'll put it as NP4 by 4 factorial, because NCR is equal to NPR by R factorial using this property. That is NPR, that is NP4 by 4 factorial, because R is equal to, this is R here. So we'll make it as NP4 by 4 factorial, and then this is a shortcut, right? You take this phi and have 5 terms, N, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 terms. N into N minus 1 till N minus 4, 5 terms. Similarly here, you have NP4, 4 terms. 1, 2, 3, 4 terms. And then you have 4 factorial. So by solving, you'll get N is equal to 5. If NPR is 240 and NCR is 120, find N and R. So again, using the same relationship property, NPR by NCR is R factorial. NPR is given, NCR is given, find R factorial. R factorial is 2. So you'll have to find what will be R. You just have to guess, right? So 2 factorial will give you 2 into 1. So take 2 factorial. Only 2 factorial is 2, right? Because 2 factorial is 2 into 1, which is equal to 2. Therefore, R is equal to 2. Now we'll have to find N. To find N, you got the R value here. Substitute R here. So you'll get NP2 is equal to 240. Or you can use NC2 is 120. Take either of them. What is NP2 is 240? NP2, 2 terms. N into N minus 1, 2 terms. This is equal to 240. So N into N minus 1 is 240. Multiply this. You're going to get N square minus N is equal to 40. So you're going to get this quadratic equation. Again, using that roots formula. This formula, you'll have to get the roots. You'll have to use plus or minus here. 1 plus 31, 1 minus 31. Take the positive number, because N has to be positive. It can't be negative. So with this, I've come to the end of revision of permutations and combinations. Thanks for watching.